Your attention, please. The Casey Jones Morning Express now arriving on track 29.
Well, hi, gang. Your old buddy Casey Jones. According to my trusty old London watch, we're right on time and all set for breakfast with Casey for today. Are you hungry? So am I. Let's have our breakfast together. Good morning. Welcome to Breakfast with Casey for today. Here it is, Thursday. Set for a good breakfast? How about you? What do we have for our breakfast? A glass of milk, like we always have. Oh, I've got some pancakes and some bacon and some juice. So we've got a good breakfast today. I wonder where Charlie Caboose is this morning.
Blindfold me.
Okay.
Oh, you got the blindfold?
Happen to have a blindfold here.
Okay, thank
you. All right,
you.
If I put this over your eyes,
yes,
you won't be able to see.
No. Nope.
All right, we'll see what's going to happen here.
I can't breathe. Look. Oh, then my eyes.
Oh, excuse
me. Not my mouth. Thank
kinda,
you.
Kind of fell down there a little bit. Okay, how's that?
Pretty good.
All right.
Feels good.
You can't see, can you?
Can't see a thing.
How many fingers am I holding up? Can't see it.
Smells like four. No, it's easy. No, okay, he can't see. All right. Hey, Eddie? Okay, now we have several objects down here. And so what I guess, Casey will hold an object up, and then you will guess what the object is?
That's right.
Okay, he's holding an object up above you right now, Freddie. This object, you should be able to come up with this right off the top of your head.
What?
Right off the top of your head, you should be able to guess this.
Oh, a hat.
Hey!
A hat.
You got it.
That's right.
Thank you.
Very good.
Ooh, thank you.
Ooh.
Next object, please.
Next object.
Freddie should be able to tie into Casey's thoughts. Tie into his thoughts. You cannot go wrong.
Not.
A rope.
That's right.
That's it.
Very good. Thank you.
A rope. Very good.
Next object, please.
All right.
Next object, please. All right, Freddie. Take your time on this one now. Take your time, and you should be able to guess what he is holding up.
A watch.
A wristwatch, that's right.
Thank you. Ooh. Thank you.
Very good.
Impressive, eh?
Okay.
Okay.
All right, Freddie. This one, you should be able to send the thoughts into your mind. Send them, Freddie.
A telegram?
No, almost.
A letter.
A letter is right.
Very good.
Ooh, they didn't ooh.
Very good.
Come on, ooh.
They'll ooh. All right, now, Freddie, this next object, you hear a little jingling sound, but you should be able to start your thoughts with this one. Start up your thoughts, Freddie. What could this be? Unlock the secret.
A key?
A whole bunch of them.
Oh, thank you. I got it right again.
That's right. All right, one more object we've got here. All right. With this object, Freddie, you need to read Casey's mind.
Do I?
Read Casey's mind.
Okay. A book.
A book is right.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a good one.
Yeah, very good.
Okay.
Next object. I think I see something black down there. Oh, okay. This kind of object, Freddie, let's see, what can we do with this?
I think you'll ring.
It might ring into your mind, Freddie. That it should ring and dial your thoughts. Look at that. It's, the cord's not even attached.
Oh, it's for you.
Is it friendly? Is it a telephone?
You're right.
A telephone is right.
Thank you. And thank you, AT&T.
Yeah, okay. We have one final object over here.
Okay, one more.
All right, Freddie. Would you be so kind to guess this object?
What?
Would you be so kind to guess this object?
Would I be so kind?
You might have to go out on a limb to get this one, Freddy.
Oh, I know.
Branch out your ideas.
A table.
No. Let it burn into your mind, Freddy. Let this burn into your mind.
Oh, hot water?
No. Like Casey said, branch out your thoughts.
I don't know. I think I'm stumped.
Stumped?
What?
That's close.
Oh, no. All I can see is a relative.
A relative?
That's right. I seen, like, Cousin Harry.
No, I don't think so.
I think it is. Take off the blindfold.
No, I don't. Freddy, I have to tell you, you're wrong. It's a log.
No, it's Cousin Harry. Hi, Harry. I hadn't seen him in ages.
That's because he's made of wood? Is that why you're saying that?
That's right.
Ding! Got a knock-knock joke for you. Yeah, you just shaved your head, it looks like. Hey, got a joke for you. Knock-knock.
Okay. Who's there?
Who's there?
Adolf.
Adolf who?
Adolf Ball hit me the doze. That's why I talk like that.
On my old Casey's joke book, that might be able to find a joke and a riddle. I've been waiting for Hobo Harry to pop up. And
do you have a new necktie or?
Oh, well, it was new a long time ago.
I see. I have a little bit of gravy and a little bit of cranberry sauce on that necktie.
Nope, that's in case I get hungry later.
What are you up to today, Hobo Harry?
Well, I wanted to do something special for you, but first of all, I want to ask you a little mathematics. You see, a little schoolboy was walking home from school yesterday, yes. And he came up and he asked me if I knew what 5Q plus 5Q was. Do you know what 5Q plus 5Q is?
How much is 5Q and 5Q?
10Q.
You're welcome.
Oh.
I was thinking, Charlie.
What's that?
You and I are about the same age. Let's see.
Well, maybe
what,
mentally.
23. I'm 24. But when I was in the Army, they used to have roll call, you know, and they'd call out, the sergeant would call out roll, you know, Anderson.
Yo.
Smith.
Yo.
Benson.
Yo.
Duncan.
Yo.
And that's the way they do it.
That's right.
Well, speaking of yo-yos, how are you? No.
Hey. Hey, here comes somebody now. I think that's Charlie. Hi, Charlie. Well, wait a minute.
Wait, that's not Charlie.
You kind of look a little bit like Charlie Caboose, but you look a little different. Wait a minute. You're not Charlie Caboose.
Well,
who are you?
I'm his cousin. Porky Caboose.
Are you Porky Caboose?
How you doing?
Porky.
Well, wait a minute. You're Charlie Caboose's cousin?
Yep.
Porky Caboose.
Yep.
you look a little different.
Yeah. Well, you see.
Did I see you in a cartoon or something?
No, I think you probably...
Did I see you at the Wood Lake Nature Center? Are you a guide naturalist?
I'm a misguided naturalist. No, you see, actually, you saw me over at the Minnesota State Fair, I think. I'm over at the...
The sort of the mascot? What is that character they have at...
The pig?
Ralph
Pig. You have a funny...
You have a funny laugh.
Well,
thank you. Well,
I suppose my laugh seems a little strange to you.
Well, yeah. You fit in right with my crops, you see. I run a human farm up north in Minnesota.
Are you a human farmer?
Yep.
Are you a human farmer or a human farmer's son?
I think I'm the son of a human farmer.
Well, I like your laugh, though.
Well, thank you. You're gonna...
Introduced him to my loved one, and while they were waltzing,
retired from me. Oh, ha! I remember the night and the dinner several. Now I'm knowing how much I was.
A double die.
Oh, yes, I lost my little darling.
Charlie Caboose just stepped out, and he's a little bit bashful and shy, but I'm going to tell you a few things because I'd like to show you some of the scrapbooks. Here's Charlie Caboose, Jim Barber there. He is a marvelous, does just great tricks, and here he is all set up there. Here's some pictures, you know. Charlie toured 23 foreign countries and went all over the world, 23 different nations with a USO tour, and he's marvelous. And there's Freddie, they look a little different there, don't they? Well, we'll have to ask him about that sometimes. But lots of times when we go out and do our programs, Charlie and I, and he does his so much of his marvelous act, and he really is fantastic, and I'm really lucky to have Charlie Caboose as a partner here. These are some of the pictures. That was with Blackstone Jr. And here's some more pictures and things as he's doing some of his acts. And let's see what else we got here. There's Charlie. And there's Freddie. These are some. This was out west. They traveled all over doing USO tours all over the world and then all over the United States, too, for the Air Force. Here's coming up to right now, some taken here at Channel 29. And there, I think, we were down at Mankato putting on a show. And I hope you'll get to see Freddie in person sometime. And I hope we'll be able to come around to where you live because it's just a marvelous show, and I think you'll enjoy it. A very talented man is our good friend Charlie Caboose, and I'm real lucky to have him as a partner, boy.
You swam to the left and you swam to the right. Step around the floor, kind of nice and light. Yeah, you twist around and twist around with all of your might. Stretch your loving arms way out in space. You do the Eagle Rock with style and grace. Swing your foot way around and then you bring it back. Oh. But that's what I call balling the jack.
Yeah, I better wind him up again. There, it gives him more energy.
Yeah, dog, man.
Where's the pork? Where's the pork?
It looks...
Turn off the lights.
Well, this song is so bad.
How bad is it?
It's good.
It's so bad.
Yeah. Here's I Love Onion.
All right. Yeah.
Under logs, but
Moby Dick, the great white whale, but I love Funyuns. I don't like shoes that pinch your toes or people who squirt you with a garden hose, but
we are at engine number 29. This is our happy birthday train, because it's time to sing our happy birthday song.
Happy, happy birthday to every girl and boy. Hope this very special day brings you lots of joy. Hope this birthday present you get from mom and dad will make this very special day the best you've ever had.
And now, happy birthday. Boys and girls, have a birthday today. This is Friday, May 4th. Happy birthday to Adam Sigford, Joey Soderlund, Krista Torgerson, Bruce I Love a Parade Wilson, Randy Inouye, Chris Rufa, and Kim Goes Better with Coker. And Leo the Lionhearted. John Hasselblum of the Chaska Kid. Barry La, tape operator. And Lucky Lindy. These are all the folks we want to thank who've been working hard on this show for the past 13 months. You know, Charlie Caboose has been on a weight reduction program. He said, I haven't seen him around for a while.
Let me out. Hey, would you let me out?
You hear that, kids?
Hey, open the lid.
What, open the lid? Who said that?
I'm in here.
Hey, is that you, Charlie?
Yeah, I'm inside the... Well, could you take the top off?
I'll take the top off. Hey, Charlie! What are you doing inside of that pumpkin? You're a very little man.
What?
You're about 3 or 4 inches tall. Well, what happened?
I've been working on that weight reduction program all week.
I think you overdid it.
Well, I don't know. Just a minute here. I'm going to stand on the edge of the pumpkin.
Well, no, it's kind of slippery there.
Could you maybe put the lid down for me?
I'll tell you what. I'll count out to three. You jump up, and I'll slip the cover right underneath you, okay?
Okay.
One, two, three, jump.
Oh,
are you okay?
There, I just about fell back in.
Are you comfortable now?
Yeah.
My goodness. Look how tall. He's only about 4 inches tall, kids.
I don't know what happened. I just worked out so much on that weight reduction program. All of a sudden today, I got small.
My goodness, you certainly did get small. Well, you've got to get out of the pumpkin for Halloween.
I sure had to. It was starting to smell in there.
Yeah, well, what's it like in there? Well, do you have any furniture or anything down there with you?
Well, I have something, maybe.
Well, should I take the top off again? And
well, let me get up by the edge
here.
Don't
slip. You stand right on the edge here, and I'll slip this out now. Oh, okay. Don't fall. Take it easy. Easy does it. Okay. Well, what do you got down there to make you comfortable? Well, do you need a bed or do you
walk
need a chair?
On the edge,
do you need a lamp?
No, I've got... Just a minute. I'll...
Jump back in. Wonder what he's got down there, kids, to help him. Oh, there's a little... Well, there's a stool. Is that what you sit on?
Yeah.
You sit on the stool, huh?
Yep.
Oh, what
Just
else
a
you got? You got a lamp or anything down there to read by? Are you comfortable?
Well, it's kind of dark. I have to read just from the light that comes through the eye holes there.
Well, you're okay, though, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
Let me get back over
but
here to
kids,
the
kids, we've got to figure out a way. How is, Charlie Caboose is going to get back to his normal size? He's only 4 inches tall. You have any good ideas?
Just a minute, Casey.
We'll have to work on
here, that. Here, there's a speck on your glasses.
Oh, thank you.
There. Got it.
Okay. Yeah, it's better now.
Yep.
Casey Jones was a man. Ate from a garbage can. Hadn't a friend in the world.
I got you guys a Valentine, too.
Really?
You see this?
This big one?
These are neat. Yeah. You see this one? I love these because they have such funny sayings on them. This one says, wise guy. Another good one is, oh, you kid.
Oh, you kid.
And then, let's see, I got another one here.
Okay.
This one says, hey, man. And then I got another one here. One says, wow.
Wow.
Keen.
Oh, wait a minute, I had that upside down. It's mom.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Now, I need to use this milk can here, sir, so if you could just move your leg just for a moment here, let me bring out the cards.
I always seem to talk very fast, too.
Hello, sir. We're going to do a card game for you today.
Oh, that
would you
would
like
be
to
nice.
See a card game? Yes, this is a guessing game. Are you good at guessing, sir?
I'm good at guessing,
well,
yes.
Very good. We're going to let you have a chance to guess right here. This is called the Sidewalk Shuffle. And no, the Sidewalk Shuffle is not what you do in the wintertime in Minnesota going down the sidewalk. The Sidewalk Shuffle is a fast, friendly, fun card game, okay? Would
all
you
right.
like to see that, sir?
I'd like to see that.
Well, very good. What we use there, sir, is just three cards. You see, we have three white cards, and we have one card that is printed, the Ace of Clubs. Sir, I'm sure that you are an ace in yourself, but I'm going to show you this card game right now.
Okay.
Now, all we do is simply take one of the blanks and place it down here on the milk can face down.
Okay.
The other ace we place right here in the middle between the two blank
cards. The other ace we place in the middle. Okay.
Well, I shouldn't have said the other ace because this is our only ace, but we have two blank cards, okay?
All right, okay.
Place the ace between the two blanks, and the object is to locate and keep track of where the ace is. Now, I'm going to show you very simply where we have.
All right.
We have a blank card on the bottom.
Yes.
Beneath that, sir, we will place the ace, and beneath the ace, we place the other blank card, leaving the ace where?
In the middle?
The middle? No, I'm terribly sorry, sir.
Oh.
The ace is not in the middle. In fact, I've already swindled you because the ace is not even in the deck. You see, we have one, two, three cards. The ace is down here, sir, on the milk can.
Hey, how did you do that?
Well, would you like us to try this one more time?
Okay.
We'll try it one more time. We'll place one of the blanks down here on the milk can, leaving us with the other cards. Now, let me see. We should have the ace right here in the middle.
Right in the middle. Okay,
we'll try this one more time.
Okay.
The ace is in between the two blank cards.
Okay.
Okay, one more time. Let me show you the order of the cards.
All right.
We have the blank card we place on the bottom.
Okay.
All right. And beneath that, we place the ace.
All right.
And beneath the ace, we place the other blank card, leaving the ace, where do you think?
In the middle.
In the middle, you say? Well, no, I'm terribly sorry. Again, we have the blank one in the middle.
Wait a minute.
In fact, this is where the switch comes in because the ace is right here. All I do is take the ace, touch this card, and they've just switched themselves, which now leaves the ace.
Oh, my goodness.
Down here, you see. And we have the three blanks right here.
How did he do that?
Would you like to see it one more time, sir?
Okay, one more time.
One more time, the guessing game. Keep your eye on the ace. We'll place one of the blanks down on the milk can. Mix up the cards a little bit. Right now, sir, your last chance. Where do you think the ace is?
I think it's in the middle again.
Well, you're saying it's in the middle, but your eyes are telling me that you think it's on the milk can again, sir.
Yes, it's probably on the milk can.
Well, no, actually, let me show you, sir. The ace is not on the milk can.
What?
We do have a blank on the milk can. In fact, I've been swindling you the whole time because it isn't done with one ace and three blank cards. It's done with one blank card and one, two, three aces. You've just been swindled, sir, by the sidewalk shuffle.
How did he do that?
Thank you very much, sir. Now, it's time to go because I see some friends of mine who played the game last week are coming, so I must close down the shop and say goodbye. Thank you very much. We'll see you later.
Okay, goodbye. How did he do that?
Sorry. Well, there are six of my friends and I went out to my uncle's farm yesterday. He has this big apple tree.
Yes.
And we picked all of the apples and divided them up between the seven of us. There are 28 apples left on the tree, so all seven of us each got 13 apples.
7 of you got 13 apples.
Yeah, because there were 28 on the tree, so we each got 13.
Wait a minute. 7 goes into 28.
Yeah.
That doesn't come out to 13.
Well, here, let me show you here. I'll use this marker, all right? We'll just write it on here.
What kind of arithmetic is... are you going to prove this to
me? Each of us had 13 apples, okay? We each got 13 apples times 7 people.
Okay.
All right? 7 times 3 is 21. 21. 7 times 1 is 7. You add that up, you get 28. So we each... there are 28 apples total, 7 people, and we each got 13, right?
Wait a minute. 7 into 28, 13. I don't understand.
Well, here, all right. Here, let me show you. 7... divided into 28, all right?
Okay.
7 doesn't go into 2, but 7 goes into 8 one time. You bring down the 7, that leaves 21. 7 goes into 21 3 times. 13.
Hey, wait.
Out of 7, you see.
I didn't take arithmetic like that.
No, see, there's 28 apples, 7 people, we each got 13.
Well, how do you get 13 out?
See, if we added them up, see, we could have 13 plus 13 7 times, and we'd get 28 apples.
Oh, my goodness. Wow, that doesn't quite seem right.
All right, here, well, maybe this will be easier if I'll stack them up, all right?
Okay.
We have 13.
All right.
And 13.
4, 5, 6,
7 people each got 13 apples.
Okay.
That equals 28.
All right.
Right?
Equals 28, what do you mean?
Well, see, if you add them up, you have 3.
3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21.
22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. 28 out of 13, 7 times.
What?
That's why we all get... Well, if you see my 28 apples, or my 13 or the 7 people, would you send them over? Because I'm getting awful hungry, okay?
Oh, my.
We'll see you later.
Did you figure that out, kids? 3, 6, 9, 12. Well, so long. It's been good to know ya. So long. It's been... Time to say so long. So long, Charlie.
So long, Casey.
So long, Freddie.
So long, Casey.
Bye, so long, Charlie. Gang. See you tomorrow morning at 7. Have a nice day. That's it.
Yeah,
marvelous. Marvelous.